ready today. All ready to get warmed up, right?
Yeah.
Ready to get warmed up. So this is week two on our 6-week challenge, renewing our minds. So what we want to ponder this week is asking ourselves, how can I best fuel my body? How often do we eat where we're not really thinking about fueling our body? We're thinking of, oh, it tastes good or whatever. What food or activity will energize me? You know, I think that's a really good thing. That helps me in my eating. I think what kind of food is going to help me have more energy? You know, it helps your mind too. And what habits are weakening my health? So that's one thing we can ponder with the Lord. I'm sure we all have habits that probably, I have a habit of complaining, honestly. I can get really, and I don't think that's good for my health because it's negative. And then I get in a cycle and then it becomes more complaining and I have to just catch myself and say, stop it, be grateful. Because my husband reminds me very gently sometimes. But we need to do that for each other, right? Pull each other up out of the mud and mire. Okay, so our scripture today, I sent out the little deal on the altar. And did anybody try that yet?
Yeah.
How did you like it? Could you feel your core activate? It really is a big core.
Yeah, and everything.
It is, it's like an overbody workout, right? I love it because it strengthens. And when you add a push-up with it, and I know some people have a hard time with their wrists. It can be really painful to put that weight on your wrist. So if you have weights, you can put them down like this, and I can keep my wrist straight now. So I can still do a full altar, and you wanna make sure that your hips aren't up too much, and so you wanna use your abs to kind of pull down and try to make it straight. And if you're going like this, it means you definitely need to be on your knees because you need enough strength to hold yourself straight. And so if you're doing a push-up, you can go down. I see my wrists don't bend at all. And the other thing when we do push-ups, we may do them today, depends if it works into class. The movement going down is where you want to start. And only going down a little bit and back up. This is your very beginning push-up, just like this, core is tight. As you get stronger, you go down further. And once you can make it all the way down, then you can start, you know, thinking about pushing it up because it takes a lot more strength to go up than down. But it works your muscles going down too. So those are just a few tips as you do the altar. We'll do it today. And a little extra hip stretching. Okay. So the scripture that came with that is Romans 12:1. Therefore I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. And I think as we ponder these things, that helps us a little bit. As we think of our bodies as a temple of the Holy Spirit, right? So what can I do to honor you, Lord? It's not always about what my flesh wants. My flesh wants to eat that whole cake, because I love cake. But I have to have discipline. And then it's really interesting because in this week two, the scripture is, so we did Romans 12:1 with the altar, Romans 12:2, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. So I think really when we put those two scriptures together, as God renews our mind, we will then be more in his will, right? So that's what we're thinking about. So everybody go ahead and get in your foundation, stand nice and tall. Turn that on, okay. Feet close together. Better balance a little bit further apart. If you can have them close together, that's great. Drawing in your abs, tuck your tailbone under. Just become tall through the spine. Let your shoulders, just roll your shoulders back a little bit and just let them relax down. Stand nice and tall. Take a long, deep breath. Let your mind calm down a little bit. Exhale slowly. Keep breathing. Lord, help me to be disciplined in the care of my physical body and to care about my health and habits. Help me to discipline my body and put to death my fleshly nature. Forgive me, Father, for the times that I do not treat my body as a temple of the Holy Spirit. Renew my mind in this area today, my wonderful Maker. So, Lord, we just come to you today that you would renew our minds, our hearts, and that each of us will listen to our bodies today.
You spread out the sky.
Stand nice and tall, take a deep breath.
Empty space. Said let to a dark and formless
world. A little bit taller, getting ready for the movement. Here we go, open up. You spread out. Hold it here.
You spread out your arms.
servant. And draw it into prayer. And pray. Nice secret. And now we're on forward. And back. Okay, there we are. That's our pattern here. Here we go. Let's do it again. Inhale. Exhale, sit your hips back. Inhale, prayer. Exhale, pray. Open up. Round. And here. And bring your arms down into a circle. Nice and slow. Inhale. Exhale.
Just
arms are reached to the side.
Press your feet into the floor and
your legs activated. Everybody press up on your legs. Here we go. Press, release. Oh wait, this is, we're doing triceps. Sorry, I got ahead of, sorry. Okay, so press out with your legs. It's a small lift up. Just lifting your triceps. Spine is tall, hinge at your hip. Small pulse on your legs, pressing out. Now depending on your flexibility, if this is not easy to grab this, you don't have to use the block, just don't even hold the block. This works good. Or you can put a block in each hand. Remember we talked last week how that block keeps you from making a fist. It helps you focus on your triceps. Are you feeling your triceps, ladies?
Yes.
Right here? Okay, let's keep going a little bit more. That's good you're feeling them. We want to really get to know our triceps better today.
Pressure
in on that block. Good. Press in, pull down. painful. Do you feel the difference as you go the different levels and you're working the entire chest? Okay. You don't need anything in your hands. Shake out your legs if you need to. You can do the standing or the wide squat again. If your legs need to be relaxed. Okay. So round, reach. So round forward. Pull back. Reach out. Go get it. Now reach down into your lats. Round forward. So this is backward. Pull. Water.